In exactly 341 days, downtown Vancouver will be the site of the opening ceremonies of the 2010 Olympic Games. Here tonight, not quite as big an event, but for hockey fans in British Columbia, they're billing it as one of the biggest games of the year. The Sedins and the rest of the Canucks have this team on a hot stretch, facing a Sharks team that's hit their toughest stretch of the year. Travis Bone making his San Jose Sharks debut tonight in teal. First of all, for the Sharks, Todd McClellan predicted it all year long when things were going really well that the Sharks would hit a tough stretch. They've hit it now. They've lost three in a row, four of their last five. They haven't really played consistently well for about 3 weeks' time, and it kind of all came to a head in that collapse the other night against Minnesota.
Nine in a row. Now they've won 11 of their last 13, the best record in the National Hockey League since February 3rd. And you know, the top line, Sedin, and Burrows are the guys that are really getting it done, and Roberto Luongo is back to his usual type of play. Matt Sedin has finally got himself acclimatized to Vancouver. His hands are back, his legs are back. This is a very different team than the Sharks have played a few weeks ago.
In goal, Brian Boucher starting again. And he'll make his fifth straight start tonight in the absence of Evgeny Nabokov, who's on the shelf. Four goals allowed on 36 shots for Boucher on Thursday night against the Minnesota Wild. And Roberto Luongo back in the lineup once again for the Vancouver Canucks after his long layoff due to injury. Started slowly in his first five games back. He went 2-3. And since then, Luongo has been red hot, 11-1 over his last 12 games. Alain Vigneault and the Canucks now with a little bit of a comfort zone in the top eight in the playoffs. And now they can begin starting to look ahead of them and try and get into the top four, which would give them at least home ice in the first round of the playoffs. Now Ryan Johnson, and now we got a fight at center, and Darcy Holichuk dropped his gloves and just started pounding on Jody Shelley, and I'm not sure what precipitated it, but that ended in a hurry. Holichuk with a smile as he skates over to the penalty box. I'm not sure what that was all about.
Neither am I. They looked at each other, and they were right by the bench. Here's Jody Shelley, and Darcy Holichuk is just going to kind of follow him up through the neutral zone. Follow him. Slash. Drops his glove. Boom, boom. Oh, he got him with the right shot. Hit him with the right hand. Put him right down. That's why he got up smiling.
Alex Edler to Olin. And the one-timer. Fires it low into the net. It's 1-0 Vancouver.
Good screen set up in front as well by the Vancouver Canucks. Theodore's shot, and Alex Burrows is right in front. Watch Burrows set up in front. Boucher's got to lean one way, and the shot goes back the other way. It's a rocket from Edler. Everything's set up fine. Marc-Evert Vlasic just gets pushed out of the way. And it's enough of a screen that throws off Brian Boucher. And geez, isn't that funny, Randy? Three games in a row where there's been a fight in the first period. The Sharks have given up the next goal.
Mitchell down low. Kessler for Dimitra. Moving to the front of the net is something. Matt Sundin takes advantage. 2-0 Vancouver.
Brad Lukowich gets burned on this play. He notices Matt Sundin makes a quick turn towards him in front of the net. Lukowich now finds Matt Sundin, takes that step, wants to take away the pass, and Matt Sundin slips by on the other side. There goes Boyle, and then Lukowich goes to the same position where Sundin was, but Sundin changed his direction, went right to the front of the net, and there's 562. Number goal 562. Number 562 as far as goals for Matt Sundin, and the Sharks are in a hole to start off this game. Less than 7 minutes in.
Right now, the ice looks like it's tilted. The shots are 7-2 Vancouver, and the Sharks are fighting the puck and just don't seem to be in rhythm at all. in Vancouver on the HB Intermission Report. It's the Canucks leading the San Jose Sharks 2-0. We were scheduled to have one of the Sharks join us live in this first intermission, but there was a bit of a closed-door meeting in the dressing room, and I'm sure the coaching staff talking about that first period. Drew, what didn't you like? Because obviously they didn't.
Defensively, I thought the San Jose Sharks were all over the map. They were focused strictly on the puck. They weren't communicating. They weren't at all moving to the right positions. They weren't taking away time and space. I thought they settled down as the game went on, but mostly it was all Vancouver Canucks that period.
Well, let's go to the highlights, and the Canucks did their damage early with two quick goals, but first some rough stuff to set the tone.
It's a loose shot by Daniel Sedin, and Darcy Horichuk and Jody Shelley, good right hand, and just puts Jody Shelley right down. Shelley tries to come back with a big hit, but Alexander Edler got the first goal. This was after the Shelley fight. Boom, right in the net, perfectly placed screen, and almost deflection by Alex Burrow, standing right in front of Brian Boucher. Then Matt Sundin, this was the terrible D-zone coverage. Two Sharks defensemen go to one guy and leaves the wide open Matt Sundin for the easy goal.
Shots on goal in the period, 10 each. Dan Boyle had three shots on goal for the 25-18 the shots. Daniel Sedin, a game-high seven shots. Devin Setoguchi, a game-high five hits. One man back, the Exa. Setoguchi trying to maneuver around him. The Exa made a nice play. Now Setoguchi coming back, takes a penalty. Yeah. Oh, boy.
Oh, man. Man, oh, man, oh, man. This is a poorly officiated hockey game. Very rarely do I come out and call these guys out to the point where I say it's a poorly officiated game. This is a poorly officiated game.
You don't know what you're talking about, do you?
And the reason it's a poorly officiated game is because there's no consistency.
You're a bit far into my set. You don't know what you're talking about.
That's a penalty by Devin. And it's a terrible, terrible, undisciplined penalty. That's a dumb play by Devin Setoguchi. How does a team that's one of the most penalized teams in the league versus a team that's one of the least penalized teams in the league, how do they get the advantage of power plays?
I don't have some way to put it. That's the way it is.
Sedin drops it for Brother Henry. And now it's 4-on-3, and there's the goal. Kevin Bieksa makes it 3-1.
That's what happens when you think of yourself first and you don't think of the team. And Devin Setoguchi is guilty right there of that. A 4-on-3 power play puts the other team in such an advantageous position. So much more room. There's the one-time shot. Brian Boucher's mad at himself as he slides over to the right. Shot goes to the left. Just misses it. But to put your team in that situation.
Can't do it.
No.
Makes the shot. Missed the net. Shot that hits the outside of the net, the game is over. Well, I think this one boiled down to the first period, Drew Remenda, when the Canucks came out with a little more passion than the Sharks. They got those two quick goals, and after that, they were able to hold that lead for the rest of the night.
Came down to a couple other things, too. The San Jose Sharks' best players are not the best players on the ice right now. And the other thing is, the San Jose Sharks' smarts, well, they got to kick them into gear because they had a couple of boneheaded plays tonight that cost them.
Final score here in Vancouver. Sharks 3, or Canucks 3, Sharks 1. We'll be back to wrap it up from British Columbia. Let's check our round table play of the game. It's Kevin Bieksa's power play goal in the third, Drew, that kind of put this one out of reach.
A 4-on-3 power play gives you a lot of room. So the one-timer set up. Bieksa, good shot low on the ice. Brian Boucher, mad. He slides across. Pretty good shot by Kevin Bieksa. That was when Devin Setoguchi took an undisciplined penalty and was in the box. That gives you so much of a boost. You score that late goal, that insurance goal, and the Sharks never were able to come back and really mount any kind of a threat to get back in this game.
Well, for the first time this year, the Sharks have lost four in a row. They have now lost five of their last six, and I think you can officially say they're in a slump.
The Sharks' top players, Joe Thornton, Patrick Marleau, they've got to be a lot better. Joe Thornton especially. Tonight, this may have been one of the worst games I've seen Joe play as a San Jose Shark. The best players, if you're going to be a great team, have to be the best each and every night. They have to work to be the best. They have to work to make an impact. That didn't happen tonight for the Sharks.
So, the Canucks finally find a way to beat the Sharks. It had been a seven-game winning streak for San Jose, and it sets up a possible, very interesting playoff matchup should these teams meet in the postseason, which has never happened before.
Well, a couple of things Vancouver does very well against the Sharks. One, they don't turn the puck over that often. Two, they make the defense for the Sharks turn.